Using current transducers for automotive diagnostics. In this video, we will look at and compare current transducers from different manufacturers. For convenience, we divide the current transducers into two groups. Current transducers used to measure small currents. Current transducers which measure high currents. Let's start with the first group. We will conduct a test to check the performance of a working fuel injector on a gasoline engine. Let's use the USB Autoscope 4 to record the injector control signal using these current transducers. First channel, CTi-50. Second channel, CTi-M. Third channel, Hantek CC-65. Fourth channel, Tecpel CA60. Fifth channel, voltage pulse on the controlled pin of the fuel injector. The waveforms are very similar. You can see the characteristic opening and closing points of the injector. Next, we will test fuel pump current waveform. We connect the current transducers to the fuel pump wiring. Let's make a detailed analysis on the recorded signals. Let's take a look at the fuel pump. Let's compare these signals with each other. They are practically the same. Conclusion: when working with relatively slow signals, current transducers work well. Now, let us see how well these current transducers perform with fast signals. This is a Mercedes-Benz Sprinter 319 CDI engine. Bosch Piezo injectors are installed on this engine. Let us analyze the waveform of common rail system Piezo injector control. Consider the recorded signal. We see that depending on the operating mode of the engine, the number of injections changes. Here we see 3 injections per cycle. Two injections. One injection. The injector current here is taken simultaneously by 4 current clamps. First channel, CTi-M. Second channel, CTi-50. Third channel, Hantek CC-65. Fourth channel, Tecpel CA-60. Let's consider the control signal in detail. Let's zoom in and observe in more detail the beginning of the opening of the piezo injector. By superimposing the waveforms on top of each other, we can easily see if there are any differences in the waveform. The waveforms produced by the different current clamps do differ from each other. What is the reason for the difference? Most likely the reason is that the current clamps have different speeds and different frequency ranges of their measurements. Let's check it on a special stand. The stand consists of a signal generator connected to a power amplifier. This is the conductor in which we will measure the current using current clamps. The load is a 10-ohm reference shunt. The signal from the shunt is connected to the first input of a two-channel oscilloscope. The first input is the yellow line on the screen. Let's check the performance of the stand. We give a signal with a frequency of 1 kHz from the generator. Let's increase the frequency to 10 kHz. Let's increase it to 100 kHz. Let's increase the frequency to 1 MHz. Ideally, current clamps should show exactly such signals. On the second input of the oscilloscope, in turn, we will apply the signal from the current clamp. First test is the current clamp CTi-M. This is how a current pulse with a frequency of 1 kHz looks like. We increase the frequency to 10 kHz. We increase to 100 kHz. Up to 1 MHz. The signal is practically non-existent. The second test is the Hantek current clamp. This is what a current pulse looks like at a frequency of 1 kHz. We increase the frequency to 10 kHz. We increase to 100 kHz. Further up to 1 MHz. There is practically no signal. The third test is the Tecpel current clamp. This is what a current pulse looks like at a frequency of 1 kHz. We increase the frequency to 10 kHz. We increase to 100 kHz. The signal is heavily distorted. We increase to 1 MHz. The fourth test is CTi-50 current clamp. This is how the current pulse at a frequency of 1 kHz looks like. We increase the frequency to 10 kHz. We increase to 100 kHz. We increase to 1 MHz. At frequencies up to 100 kHz, the CTi-50 current clamp works well. Conclusion: the highest performance was shown by the CTi-50 current clamp. These current transducers have another advantage, the size of their jaws. They are small, allowing you to connect anywhere. Consider the operation of current clamps of high currents. Here is the waveform of the engine start signal. We see four signals. Channel number 1, APPA 32. Channel number 2, APPA 36T. Channel number 3, APPA 39T. Channel number 4, Hantek CC-650. We can superimpose signals on each other. They are practically the same. Let's do another test. The power amplifier cannot work with high currents. Therefore, in order to measure small currents with high current clamps, it is necessary to wrap the measuring wire several times around the magnetic core. Three turns will increase the current in three times. 10 turns will increase in 10 times. The current clamps are designed to measure the current in a wire passing through the jaw of the instrument once. By adding turns, we are strengthening the magnetic field that the instrument is seeing. 3 turns is 3 times as strong. 10 turns is 10 times as strong, and so on, up to a point. Let's prepare the stand for measurements. Replace the measuring wire with a coil of 10 turns. Reference shunt, 2 ohm. Pulse amplitude, 10 volts. The current in the circuit is 5 amperes. In this case, current clamps can work with current pulses of 50 amperes. The first test is the APPA 39T current clamp. This is what a current pulse looks like at a frequency of 500 Hz. We increase the frequency to 1 kHz. We increase to 5 kHz. The second test is the APPA 36T current clamp. This is what a current pulse looks like at a frequency of 500 Hz. We increase the frequency to 1 kHz. We increase to 5 kHz. Third test is the Tecpel CC-600 current clamp. This is what a current pulse looks like at a frequency of 500 Hz. We increase the frequency to 1 kHz. We increase to 5 kHz. Fourth test is the Hantek CC-650 current clamp. This is what a current pulse looks like at a frequency of 500 Hz. We increase the frequency to 1 kHz. We increase to 5 kHz. Fifth test is the Tecpel CC-1000 current clamp. This is what a current pulse looks like at a frequency of 500 Hz. We increase the frequency to 1 kHz. We increase to 5 kHz. Let's compare the measurement results. Conclusion: almost all high current clamps can be used in the diagnostics of automotive equipment. But in practice, the size of the current clamp jaws is also important. When looking at the size of the jaws, the APPA 36T and APPA 39T have advantages.